I am also interested, though, in the war this now sets up in some ways between the Lakers and the Celtics, because those are the two teams that just in this short hour or two have already come to the fore in terms of teams that will be really throwing trade offers at the Spurs. Does Greg Popovich have any interest in helping the LA Lakers? Probably not. When you're talking about Danny Ainge in a room trying to convince you of things versus Magic Johnson. Look, the Lakers, Jeannie Buss wanted Magic involved because she and Magic have great trust, mm-hmm. but also because she wanted Magic involved to help convince potential free agents, or in this category, guys who want to get traded out of a situation. Hey, I'm Magic Johnson. You can trust me. Mm-hmm. Come play with me. You've got Danny Ainge, though, on the other side. Obviously a great luminary in the league, too. What can you enlighten us on the Popovich sort of Lakers, where that stands, too, with how much he might want to help them?
I mean, given the history, given his indignation over the Pau Gasol trade that may or may not still be present, given that they are in the Western Conference, I don't see Greg Popovich, all things being equal, endowing this Lakers team with that kind of asset. I mean, one thing I do want to ask, I think we make too much of this, who's good in the room. Michael Jordan owns the Charlotte Hornets. Michael freaking Jordan. Michael Jordan, who essentially designed the image and the icon of the modern NBA athlete, the modern athlete period. Mm-hmm. Is anybody on his doorstep? I just think that this in the room thing is so overrated.
It's a closer, though. I mean, I don't think you're going to a bad team because even if Michael's in the room, but I mean, if you...
Well, again, if Michael comes in a room, just like Magic Johnson comes into a room, you're going to get attention. Right. I mean, obviously the player is going to look and be like, whoa, this is Michael Jordan or this is Magic Johnson. You know, you're going to be overwhelmed for a certain amount of time. So I think that does have a wow factor when it comes to trying to convince a player to come to Los Angeles or to come to Charlotte, wherever the case may be. But at the end of the day, you know, like you said, the player is going to try to make the best decision for him. I think Pop does not want to make the Lakers a better basketball team. And I think Boston would love to help him not do that as well. So I think it's going to be interesting to see how this all kind of plays out. But at the end of the day, you know, you're taking a chance with Kawhi, because if you do trade him, that team that he gets, he can be gone after a year.
Right, yeah. And you're talking about potentially giving up a lot of assets. And also, as I like to tell everyone, don't ever trade with Danny Ainge because right. he is so
to get
good
the best
at
out
it.
Of the deal, yes.
Now, maybe R.C. Buford and Pop are like the one other sort of category of people, I would say, are savvy enough to sort mm-hmm. of make sure it's an even deal. But Boston fans are the first ones to tell you they've got a magician in their corner. Can you just tell me what you've been getting from texts? You said you've been texting with
Yeah, it's
offices.
Really interesting. You know, nobody feels the Spurs are over a barrel. No one feels like, oh, well, you know, Kawhi's named his destination. Their hand is forced. They can't bring him back. He's under contract for another year, but that would be misery. I mean, I think there's a sense that they can be patient. They can hold out. There will be other teams that are emboldened as players drop off the free agent market. Again, I think there's also a sense this isn't going to happen in the next week or so. But, again, this is just a poll. I mean, I do want to say that, celebrities help in the room, mm-hmm. but I think it's the quality of the vision. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, the reason Danny mm-hmm. Ainge is Danny Ainge is he articulates mm-hmm. and delineates a series of principles about what happens when you come to the Boston Celtics. I mean, yeah, he was a former pro and he's won championships, but I do think the quality of the vision, I think, yes, Magic, it's much greater than zero. I mean, the presence of the person in the room is something, but I just think it's the quality of the vision.
I think the timing of this is so fascinating, too, because, again, if this trade, whatever it is, happens before free agency and maybe in concert, in back rooms, not that that ever happens in the NBA, no one talks to each other. There's no tampering. No one ever has any idea of any future plans. Uh-huh. But just for saying, if this trade happens before the free agency market sort of pops at the beginning of July, that is a very different question of dominoes and where they're falling and players who may have and are allowed to talk to each other versus the Spurs, who, as you said, have a say in this. Kawhi doesn't get to go anywhere until they say he does.
Right.
So it might be that LeBron James or Chris Paul or Paul George are forced to make these decisions without knowing where Kawhi Leonard is. And by the way, it's not just, oh, gee, would we come to a team that he plays on? If Kawhi might be going to Boston, and you're LeBron and you're deciding, do I want to go to the West or do I want to stay in the East? Which side is more competitive has changed even with that equation. So there's so many things going on here.
Greg Popovich is not going to convenience 29 other teams. No. That's the thing. And why should he?
Right. So I mean, it'll be interesting. And also, by the way, Greg Popovich said to LaMarcus Aldridge last summer, you might want a trade, you're not getting a trade. Now, this is obviously a different scenario. Kawhi only having that year left on his deal sort of changes a lot of the equation here. And also the value of Kawhi Leonard and what he could bring back. One thing Pop told LaMarcus is like, hey, you can get me a great player, a Kevin Durant, he said to him, or anyone else, like a great exchange. He goes, I'll pack your bags, I'll drive you to the airport. I have the feeling the Spurs will get some pretty good offers for Kawhi Leonard, not Kevin Durant, but maybe Greg will be packing bags and driving to airports. Who knows? We'll see.